At the center of our galaxy is a black hole with the mass of 4 million suns called Sagittarius A star. Around it is a complicated structure of dust and gas, and after 12 years of peering into it, astronomers have discovered several objects they weren't expecting to find. Objects that have some unusual characteristics. They're called G-objects, and they orbit around Sagittarius A star and have a dusty appearance. The first one, imaginatively called G1, was found in 2004. G2 was spotted in 2012, and G3, G4, and G5 were just announced in the summer of 2018. There's no G6 yet, but I expect when they find it, it'll move with a sort of Far East movement. Nobody under 20 gets that reference. They look like dust clouds. So what, you might wonder. Well, astronomers thought they might just be dust clouds too. Back when only G1 and G2 had been spotted, they had a very similar orbit. So one hypothesis was they were once part of the same dust cloud that had been stretched out until it formed smaller clumps, like beads on a string, a process that has been observed elsewhere in the universe. But when these fast-moving objects pass close to Sagittarius A star, they didn't behave how dust clouds should. See, a supermassive black hole would rip a dust cloud to shreds, but G1 and G2 stayed intact, so they must be something else entirely. Astronomers deduce that they most likely have a stellar core that's massive enough to keep them intact. So they're probably stars. Huge stars that are so big and bloated that as they pass by the black hole, the tidal forces rip matter out of the stellar atmosphere. G objects are bigger and put out more energy than typical stars too. So in all likelihood, they're two stars that have merged together. It's possible that binary star systems around Sagittarius A star could be forced together because of the black hole's influence. This merger would boost energy output and give the new object a distended appearance, perhaps for millions of years until the new object settled down and looked more like a normal-sized star. If these G objects are in fact merging binary stars, they could help us learn what causes stellar mass black holes mergers too, like the ones we've recently detected using gravitational waves. G3, G4, and G5 have yet to be observed passing close by Sagittarius A star, so we'll keep a close eye on them to make sure they really are G objects that stay intact. The next G object we can observe fly close to the black hole will be G3, 20 years from now. Until then, we'll keep studying them to learn more about the chaotic environment at our galaxy center. Keep track of G objects and all space stuff by subscribing to our channel, and to find out what black holes sound like when they smash into each other, check out Marin's video here. These new G objects were spotted and tracked thanks to special software that mapped spectral data from our galactic center in 3 dimensions. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.